Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the last video, we started learning about geometric sequences, but we'd only looked at examples where the common ratios were positive whole numbers. In this video, we're going to do more examples with different types of common ratios. Here's a sequence, but something's weird about it. The numbers keep alternating signs, negative, positive, negative, positive. Are we sure this is even a geometric sequence? Let's check for a common ratio. Negative 1 times what would be 2? Negative 1 times negative 2 is 2. The reason the sign changed was because we multiplied by a negative number. Does that also work for the next term? From 2 to negative 4, we would multiply by negative 2. And then from negative 4 to 8, multiply by negative 2 again. So the common ratio is negative 2. Anytime the common ratio is negative, the terms will alternate between negative and positive. So what's the next term? Well, the fifth term will be the fourth term times negative 2, which is negative 16. Here's another weird one. The numbers are getting smaller, not bigger. But aren't geometric sequences supposed to multiply? Let's see if we can find a common ratio that would make this happen. This one will be a little harder to find, so let me show you a trick. You could find any common ratio by dividing a term by its previous term. So in this case, we take the second term and divide it by the previous term. When we reduce this fraction, we get 1/3. So the ratio between 729 and 243 is 1/3. We'll get the same thing between the other terms. 81 divided by 243 is 1/3. And 27 divided by 81 is 1/3 as well. Now that we know the common ratio, what's the next term? The fifth term will be the fourth term times 1/3, which is 9. Pause the video and see if you could find the common ratio and the next two terms in this sequence yourself. In order to find the common ratio, we'll use the dividing trick again. The second term, negative 25, divided by the previous term, 125, reduces to negative 1/5. The second and third terms also come out to negative 1/5, and same with the third and fourth ones. So then if the common ratio is negative 1/5, the fifth term is negative 1 times negative 1/5, which is 1/5, and the sixth term will be 1/5 times negative 1/5, which is negative 1/25. Geometric sequences can cause some interesting patterns, but they're still just based on basic multiplication. In the next lesson, we're going to learn how to write formulas to generate geometric sequences, just like we did with arithmetic sequences. See you then.